So way back in 1984, there was a movie that came out called The Karate Kid, which was about this kid who moves from New Jersey to Los Angeles and just kind of like wreaks havoc for a while by stealing this guy's girlfriend and then kicking him in the face. And this went on to become one of the most well-known, beloved 80s movies of all time. Now fast forward to 2018, where we finally got the answer to the question that we've all been asking ourselves, how dumb can people get? But also, whatever happened to this guy? And now we have the first true sequel, Cobra Kai. But before that, really quick, this video is sponsored by Audible. If you don't know what Audible is by now, Audible is an online service that lets you download audiobooks, audio newspapers, and just like all kinds of spoken word entertainment. Right now, if you sign up with my link, audible.com/AlexMyers, or text my name, Alex Myers, to 500-500, you can get a 30-day free trial where you get one free audiobook and unlimited Audible Original monthly downloads. Now, Audible Originals are exactly what they sound like. Audiobooks are some kind of like audio entertainment thing that you can't find anywhere else, or exclusive versions of books like The Adventures of Tom Sawyer read by Nick Offerman, for example. And once you've signed up, you continue to get one free audiobook regardless of price and unlimited Audible Original monthly downloads for just $15. Now, a lot of these audiobooks are between $15 and like $30 anyway, so you're actually saving quite a bit of money by signing up. And here's the thing, whatever audiobooks you download, even the free one you get with the 30-day free trial, you get to keep forever, even if you cancel the membership, so like you literally have nothing to lose. This week I like to recommend a book called Quiet, which is about being an introvert and kind of like what that means or what it doesn't mean, and it goes pretty in depth about how to manage your introversion in like different situations, or like if you're dating an extrovert, for example, how you can compromise on each other's needs, that kind of thing. It's pretty interesting stuff. So once again, sign up with my link, audible.com/AlexMyers, or text my name, Alex Myers, to 500-500, start your 30-day free trial, get your free audiobook, I mean, come on!
Okay, back to the show.
Now, this guy who got kicked in the face is named Johnny Lawrence, and after all this happened, his life just kind of went downhill, and now he lives in this terrible apartment that actually doesn't seem that bad compared to places I've lived.
Hey, I'm Miguel. My family and I just moved into 109. But anyways, I was just wondering if you were having trouble with your water pressure, because I know our sink's being a little weird right now. And, oh, bottle's going in the blue bin.
Listen, pipes don't work, fountain's full of piss. And the only good thing about being here is I don't have to talk to anybody.
Or then there's his blue-collar job that would probably afford him a pretty okay lifestyle, more or less, if he just wasn't so jaded all the time. But yeah, but clearly this is all out of his control, right? Because, I mean, hey, if you can't be a winner in high school, then what's the point of even trying anymore?
Whoa. What the hell is this?
Don't worry, it's gonna be level. I'm just lining it up.
You put it on the wrong wall. I said the wall across from the door. Just move the TV. I have company coming over.
Okay. We'll figure this out, all right? Just quit bitching at me.
So he ends up getting fired and reaches his absolute lowest moment, where we see him sitting outside his local convenience store eating a piece of pizza on the sidewalk. Well, I mean, the pizza's in his hand, he's sitting on the sidewalk. Although let's not pretend that we all haven't had a craving now and then for some of that good old
sidewalk pizza.
Tastes like sadness.
Anyway, so as he's doing this, he sees that kid from earlier getting bullied by some local ne'er-do-wells, and at first Johnny doesn't really care either way because, you know, helping people is for losers. But then they bump into his car, and y'all know what that means. However, the police show up and immediately arrest him, as if this 50-year-old guy is just walking up to a bunch of teenagers minding their own business, you know, and he's like, hey, what are you doing over there? You're making them TikToks? Not on my watch. Anyway, so after he gets out of jail, he goes back to his apartment where he meets that kid one more time who wants to thank him for helping him last night.
Hey, I just wanted to say thank you. Do you think you could teach me?
What? No.
What? Come on. When school starts, those guys are gonna make my life miserable.
That's not my problem.
If I just knew a little bit of what you knew, then I would be
fine. Forget it. All right, you want my advice? Stop being so annoying.
Oh, man. I wish someone had told me that back in high school. Heck, if I could, I'd tell 15-year-old me all kinds of things, like randomly going up to girls in the hallway and saying,
where's my hug?
It's the creepiest thing of all time, all right? So just... So he goes up to his apartment and turns out his stepdad just kind of showed up because he's the one who bailed him out of jail. Now, an extra little bit of character backstory we get here is that Johnny's mom died some time ago, so his only living relative, or whatever, is his stepdad, who, of course, he doesn't really get along with.
This is why I'm here.
What's this?
You know, I told your mama I'd take care of you always, but in this case, I think even she would cut me some slack. I'm buying you out of my life.
I'd rather be homeless and take money from you.
Later on, Johnny's car gets hit by these three girls who were texting and driving.
Mm-hmm.
And it gets towed to the nearest car dealership slash auto body shop, which just so happens to be owned by a certain someone Johnny was hoping he would never have to see ever again.
Johnny? Johnny Lawrence, I knew it was you.
In case you're unaware, this is Daniel LaRusso, the main character slash main villain of the original Karate Kid movie. But you see, while Johnny's life led him to eating pizza on the sidewalk, Daniel's been doing pretty well for himself, with his happy family and financial security and all that, so yippee for you.
Hey, Anoush, come here. Louie, get over here. I want you to meet somebody.
I gotta go.
No. This is Johnny Lawrence. He and I go way back, right, buddy? This guy was the toughest dude in my high school. When I first moved here from Jersey, he and I, we got into it a little bit. All right, that's all water under the bridge.
Wait, is this the karate guy? The guy from the tournament?
Yeah, you know, this is like reason number 307 why I never go back to my hometown. Oh, hey, Alex, where? It's been so long.
Not long enough, apparently.
Hey, remember the time back in high school when you thought you were being cool and romantic and all that, and you got up in front of the whole lunchroom and asked Kelsey to go to the prom with you, and then she just said no and everyone laughed at you for the rest of the day? Yes. Yes, I do.
Every single night.
But anyway, Daniel goes off to get Johnny a complimentary bonsai tree because he's one of those people now. And as he's doing this, his daughter comes in and Johnny realizes that she was one of the girls in the SUV that hit his car the night before.
Hey, Dad.
Look who's here.
Hey, what are you doing? Open the door!
Okay.
You gotta be kidding me.
Of course. Go ahead. In the office, I think.
See you later.
Okay.
So first Daniel shows up and ruins his entire life by stealing his girl and winning a high school karate tournament. And now Daniel's daughter ruined his car, sort of. Not really. Well, I mean, she was in the back seat and had nothing to do with it. But I mean, what, you think Johnny over here is going to take responsibility for his own mistakes and react to things calmly and objectively? Psst. Come on, this ain't no bear in the big blue house. Now all this comes to a head and Johnny, in his infinite wisdom and emotional maturity, realizes that if only he could prove himself better than Daniel at one thing, then that would somehow magically turn his entire life around. So he uses his stepdad's money to rent a space for a dojo and revives his old Cobra Kai karate school alma mater, because the only time in Johnny's life when he was truly happy was when he was beating up kids on the beach for no reason and getting emotionally and physically abused by his old teacher. And the only thing he can think of to make his life better is to do all of that to someone else.
Are you sure you're ready? Because once you go down this path, there's no turning back.
You're gonna be my karate teacher?
No. I'm gonna be your sensei.
Who says that? And then the kid's face! What? I can't breathe! So the show went on for two... Okay. All right, let me try again. I got this. So then the show went on for two seasons and was recently picked up by Netflix for a third season coming out sometime next year. And I gotta say, I do really like the premise of this show, just in that, like, it takes the idea that Daniel is kind of like the bad guy in the first movie and turns that into a full-on sequel about what happened afterwards, but from the point of view of other characters. It's actually a pretty unique idea, so I think I'll probably keep watching this one. You know, 80s nostalgia, as everyone knows, is definitely nothing new. It's been around for quite a while. You know, Stranger Things came out, I believe, oh gosh, almost 3-4 years ago at this point, 5 years ago maybe, whatever it was. You know, it's all like the whole like 80s nostalgia push. And then of course, like in gaming now, there's a whole bunch of like retro gaming stuff is big. Yeah, the Ready Player One movie came out a while ago. And it's just like, you know, 80s nostalgia specifically has been such a big thing. But it's always like, you know, I don't know, it's always like a very sort of cleaned up, sanitized, kind of cherry-picked version of like 80s nostalgia, you know, like Stranger Things, whatever, where it's like, oh, all the kids are wearing Ghostbusters and they're all listening to Never-Ending Story music, and it's very, you know, in your face about it. And the thing I really like about Cobra Kai is like, it does the whole 80s nostalgia thing, but like, I don't know, it doesn't like solely rely on that, because it's like, yeah, like there's a lot of callbacks to the original Karate Kid movies, and there's a lot of like the same music and montage music and stuff that plays, but like generally speaking, it's still like, you know, what happens afterwards. But you know, it's not like they're trying to continue Karate Kid like right where it left off or whatever. It's like, you know, yeah, 34, 35 years later, what's everyone doing nowadays? And then there's the whole like, you know, good old days of the 80s kind of vibe, but it's still set in like a modern setting and it's still like its own thing that kind of pays respect to the 80s source material, but not like solely rely on the 80s nostalgia itself, which I really like, because I feel like 80s nostalgia and just kind of 80s and 90s nostalgia. Like, you know, I was a 90s kid, so I have my own 90s nostalgia, obviously. But it's definitely overdone. You know, like it's we all need to kind of make up new things. And like Cobra Kai could very much exist in its own like way, like its own thing. But the fact that it's kind of directly tied back to the Karate Kid movies, it just feels very cohesive and it feels very well put together. I really actually enjoyed it. I'm definitely going to keep watching because like it's just so different than the typical, you know, like remember the 80s type thing. So I actually had a pretty good time. Anyway, thanks so much for watching, everybody. Don't forget to subscribe. Don't forget to ring that bell so don't miss any videos from me. Follow me on Twitter if you want to. I don't really use it anymore, but go ahead. I have a new podcast. It's called Doing the Devil's Tango. It's like a dating story, dating advice, talking about ex-boyfriends, ex-girlfriends, kind of like podcast thing. So if you're interested in that, link is down below. Check it out. And above all else, everybody have a great day, and I'll see you all next time.